By now you've heard that you need eclipse glasses in order to view the entire eclipse, but some of you have asked us how to know whether your glasses are safe. Now experts say you need to open them up and look on the back and make sure it has the letters C and E. That means they're certified for safety. These glasses are about 1,000 times darker than regular sunglasses, only letting in about 1% of the sunlight, Dr. Amber Porter from Clemson says. While it's never safe to look at the sun on a regular day, it's especially important not to do so during the eclipse on August 21st. There are expensive glasses out there and there are cheaper cardboard ones. Dr. Porter says it's up to each individual on which to buy. The cheap ones will last maybe a year before they're damaged and will need to be thrown away.
Only buy the $50 ones if you're going to want to look at the sun every single day to recoup those $50. But these cardboard basic ones are just fine for the solar eclipse.
As for binoculars, don't use them unless you buy filters for the eyepieces. You'll need filters for a telescope as well. You can get sunoculars, which have filters already built in. As for cameras, Porter advises for those who aren't professional photographers not to take pictures in full totality when the sun is completely covered. That will damage your camera or device. If you can't stop yourself, she says, before totality, you can take a picture through your eclipse glasses, but warns the picture won't come out very well. Mandy Gaither, WYFF News 4 in Clemson.